right, Aries, what's up? This is Soul here, and we're going to look at some energies for you in the next 2 months regarding love and romance, June and July. So, as I mentioned in the other videos, Aries, I had set the intention to have the energy stretched this month and then going into July. But it was only after I had put up the video of me exclaiming that I would be doing these videos, okay? So if there's some confusion as to what's going on, and you know, if you know anything about tarot reading and tarot readers, that, you know, you can set your intentions for energy to at any time. And I did that prior to recording the very first one for Gemini, that I set the intentions for the energy for 2 months. Okay, so Aries, I hope all is well. I hope you guys had a wonderful birthday. So we're going to look at some energy here for you. I'm using the Victorian Romantic Tarot deck, and then also three cards I'm drawing from Sandra Brown's Love Oracle deck. And as before, you know, pulling a card, or after shuffling, the bottom card becoming the shadow, and it may be energy that may or may not play out for you. If it's a major arcana, it definitely will. And all cards are in the upright position. So without further ado, let's begin. See what's coming up for you energetically for the next 2 months when it comes to love and romance. By the way, this is for Aries who are single and Aries who are in relationships. Your shadow. In between readings, I always seem to turn the deck around and I forget this orientation. So we're going to start off with your energy already. This is a court card. This is news and surprises. Pages always are the start of something new. In this case here is being inspired. So you could be, you know, single, and you could be in a couple. You could be in a couple. You could be in a relationship, Aries. And then there's some new inspiration that sparks, that kicks in to do something differently with your partner. Or it could be that, you know, that spark hits the partner and then you're involved in that type of energy. Nonetheless, you can expect good news if it plays out, good news, and then it's something to do with surprises. For those, again, it could be someone that you meet that is younger than you. Doesn't necessarily have to be a fire sign, but it couldn't be another fire sign like yourself, Sagittarius or Leo. So we have the Page of Wands that is your shadow. So this card here is going to be the theme or the energy for the next 2 months, June and July. Some things that you may need to focus on, some things you may not need to focus on. Doesn't really matter. Let's see. Let's begin. Okay. Just like Aquarius, Aries, they received the Devil as the very first card. So this card here, now keep in mind, just because the Major Arcana, the Devil, shows up here does not indicate that that's how your entire 2 months is going to feel like. But it may be some energy, or it may be just showing up here to let you know that there's some sort of examination that you need to take a hold of when it comes to your relationships, you know, addictive behaviors. It could be actual substances like drinking, smoking, gambling. Something is restricting you. Something is keeping you bound. Something is holding you back. The snake on a shoulder could represent other influences, like other people, like your friends or family members suggesting, advising, and they're all giving you, you know, bad suggestions, bad advice. This is unrequited love, feelings going out, too much feelings going out into another person, and you're not receiving that same energy back. Ruminating thoughts, thinking about the same thing, and this is all tied into relationships, so keep that in line. About that relationship, that relationship that you can't seem to get out of your mind, and everything could be well, but then you're still thinking about this relationship like a gerbil that's inside your head on a wheel that's spinning and can't get off and can't stop. So be careful of that. It's about bad relationships. It's about toxic relationships. What's going on in terms of the Devil's influence and how that influences may have taken over a hold of you, or you know, taken over a hold of someone that you are interested in. It's a form of patterns of behavior, okay? Repetitive behavior. And you have to identify. So this is shown up here for some of you, possibly to evaluate those things for the next 2 months as it relates to you and your relationships moving forward. Okay, so the devil here represents Capricorn, Taurus, and Virgo. Up next, after that, we have the King of Swords. Just like in the Aquarius video, they had the Ace of Swords. So the King of Swords is just like that ace, where there's a lot of determination for you to get to the bottom of the source of the devil's influence. How it's affecting you and how it's affecting, the partner or your behaviors or whatever. If there's, you know, anything that you need to evaluate or discuss, this is just saying we need to bring it up to the surface and sort of get that air cleared so that we can break the chains of whatever it is that the devil is influencing us, trying to make us feel that everything is hunky-dory and grand and okay when it really isn't. The King of Swords is the sword that cuts the action, the determination, get to the bottom of things. So yes, and I always say that the red robe always represents fire energy. So then again, that would be you. This represents Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius. Now he's there sitting, but he's not, in my opinion, pondering. What he's doing is he's already made up his mind about doing something. His back is to the devil's energy. So that means that from my perspective and my intuitive senses that he's going to tackle whatever these problems or these issues are related to this, devil's influence. Okay, so there's a lot of determination. It's a card of taking action. And then afterwards, there's a lot of contentment. Okay, so King of Swords represents Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius. Up next after that, it's a court card, so it could be some, just like that page of wands in your shadow, could be somebody new coming in. Doesn't necessarily have to be an air sign, but it's an older gentleman or an older female. Next up is the Nine of Swords. So the Nine of Swords here is kind of like that Three of Swords. I don't like the Three of Swords, but the Nine of Swords is always that you can see her out on the ledge, feeling like you're edgy, you're feeling like you're out on the ledge, out on the limb. This is usually, oh look, and it mirrors the devil. So the devil, let me talk about the Nine of Swords first and how it relates to this devil's issue. I mean the devil's energy, not the necessarily issues. So mostly this is a card of lies, cheating, affairs, betrayals, past issues that are unresolved, and it mirrors the devil. That's what I wanted to say, okay? Those things may be what's restricting you, what's holding you back, what's keeping you from moving forward. Now, usually, it's not usual, but sometimes if it's involving other people or bad, you know, relationships in the past that were bad, then if you're not able to forgive the other person, then start with forgiving yourself for anything that took place in any relationship that you may have felt didn't turn out to be the best or was bad for you, okay? And then that's when the healing starts. That's when the chains and the patterns of the devil's influence starts to break up. But there's something that's unresolved here that needs to be brought to the surface and discussed so that you can clear the air. Nine of Swords, just like the King of Swords, represents Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius. And because the King is facing the Nine of Swords, that means that there's somebody who specifically is dealing with what I just mentioned. Something that has something to do with the devil's influence and is related to a past situation, but is being carried over in the present. That's impacting or affecting how you go about dealing with relationships now and then moving forward. All right. Nine of Swords. After the Nine of Swords, we have the Fool. And then the Fool represents Major Arcana, new beginnings. Always taking those risks. Okay. Stretching out to unknown territory. Do so. Okay. Because the fool in this energy will support you. There are people here. If you are single and you're wanting to take some sort of risk, go forth, okay? Go forth and do that. there's somebody here for you to meet. So you're looking for new excitement, those that I'm reading for, and adventure. Now, that's with someone in terms of a relationship. Fool is always about new beginnings and the start of something new. Following the Fool card, now we have the Tower. Now, mind you, Aries, I did say in another video that I posted yesterday, the Tower in a love reading does not necessarily mean breakups, you know, arguments and all that other stuff. I did say that, you know, we're all adults here. I'm reading for you. This could be orgasmic in nature, you know, it could be the sexual energy. And then you think of the explosions or, you know, well, you know what happens after you know, right? I don't have to get too deep with it. You know exactly what I'm talking about. So I don't want you to walk away thinking that because the Tower shows up here that this is the energy of gloom and doom. But however, I do want to, you know, bear in mind and keep in mind here and let you know that sometimes the Tower, just like the Death card comes through, it's like the, not necessarily the unspoken from the universe. It is the universe's energy. Sometimes the universe will shake things up for you because it's necessary. And remember, what is it mirroring? The Tower is mirroring the devil. So something is going to be shaken up. Now, the shake up could be something that is, you know, good for you. It all depends on you and your situation, but it's a necessity, okay? Something has to take place in order to, you know, rid yourself or break the influence of this devil's influence, whatever that influence that is over you or, you know, that the devil has over you. So you can look at it as this universe coming in here, that bolt of lightning just shakes things up. Whether we want to, sometimes these shakeups are unpleasant, but you won't find out later on that the unpleasantry that you feel at that present moment was actually a necessity that favors you later on. Okay, so I'm reading this Tower a little bit differently as opposed to, you know, gloom and doom. And, you know, the water here, it's like they're on a cross and they're waiting for someone to rescue them and it's like they have no hope or whatever. So no, this could be orgasmic in nature, sexual energy, and then it also could be a message from the universe that they're about to shake something up in your world, but because it may be something that's necessary for you to feel, or to, you know, it's necessary for you to change something, because the devil has you restricted. The devil is keeping you there, influencing you. So they're going to strike. The universe is going to strike that. Possibly in connection with the King of Swords, the determination and taking action and whatnot. Now that might be beyond your control, but I feel that the universe is really beyond your control. But this is afterwards. This could be afterwards after something happens. Okay, I need to get my ass in gear. I need to start taking action. I can't stay like this, I can't be like this, and so forth. But that might just be a thought process that comes through, and the universe might, you know, kick that into you as well. But usually it's a very powerful shakeup, a well-known one, and you will feel it in some type of way. Because if you're refusing to act on anything that's related to that devil's influence, that's when the universe kicks in. This is the Tower, that would be the Death. All right, so following the Tower of Major Arcana, we have the Four of Cups. And after all the shakeup, then there's the celebration. Here's the Four of Cups here. And the Four of Cups is a good card because one of the cups that I would like to have show up in a love reading. But this could be you. I always get social invitations, social outings, just like the Two of Cups. But this is like, could be in a small group since, you know, most of the, depending on where you live, the COVID-19 restrictions are being lessened or, you know, completely gone. And then you're out and about enjoying being around people again. If you're single, you could be out there in a social setting and then there's somebody who you can link up with romantically in that setting. Or if you're in a relationship, you're just out and about socially and enjoying each other's company, but there are other people there that are like-minded like you, okay? So this is celebrations. It could include birthdays, anniversaries, or whatever, just like the Three of Cups, but having a good time, but it's in a smaller social circle. That's what I see. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces represents that Four of Cups. Let me see if I can pick up a message related to that Four of Cups. Underneath that devil, the only thing that's coming to my mind instantly is that it could be that the devil's influence, like I mentioned about the snake, because there's many people here, it's family members or friends who have some sort of influence of energy here. And even though this is a good card, it's still, there's people here that are being influencers. And then they're giving either bad advice or, you know, making bad suggestions or something, but it's about you. It's affecting you. Okay. All right, so next card up here, Aries, is Seven of Cups. All right, so the Seven of Cups here is about Seven of Cups is also, too, that it's like the moon, almost, okay? Deal with people, see with people, or situations the way they present to you, not the way that you want it to be, because then it will save you a disappointment, emotional disappointment. Take things as they are presented. Remember, the cups is about options, so there could be also many options to pick and choose from, but I always say make sure that you are picking from the right cup. Underneath the King of Swords, that could be a relationship, you know? Could be a couple people going on here, and then, you know, you have to make a choice or a selection of, you know, two. If it's more than two, then so be it. But just be careful that you are dealing with the emotions that you need to be dealing with. And if it's definitely coming from, you know, dealing with other people. You know, like Maya Angelou say, if a person shows you who they are, you better believe them. So this is what I get with that Seven of Cups. Okay. Having to believe something that we want to believe when it's not actually real. All right. Cancer, Scorpio, and Pisces. Then we have Justice. Justice comes in here. Balanced emotions. Justice being served here, I think, being underneath the Nine of Swords. So you're going to work these issues out. I do believe, Aries, you're going to work these issues out. And then mindful that you got the Justice card and the Fool card. So they counterbalance the Tower as well as the Devil's energy. Okay, so we got that going on here. But Justice is being served. The Doves at the base of her feet always represents that peace and harmony. It could be inner peace and harmony. It could be external peace and harmony. Again, even though this represents the air signs, Libra specifically, but, you know, Gemini and Aquarius, the fire, the red cape, the red hair, that's your energy. So either dealing with other fire signs like yourself, Leo and Sagittarius, or something else is going on here, okay? But justice being served. Justice shows up here too because, you know, for all, it mirrors the Four of Cups. It could be a small wedding. Someone gets married in front of the Justice of the Peace. Or if it's here, someone gets married and doesn't have to be in front of the Justice of the Peace, but there's the reception right there after the marriage. I mean, well, before, it's before, but it's, you know what I'm talking about, because the Justice is facing this card, facing in this direction. So that would indicate a marriage or a small reception. Someone getting married in the month of June. And June is a popular month to be married in, right? So, moving right along, after the Justice card, we have... Oh, look at that, see? There you go, Aries, Three of Cups. There's the celebration. There's the birthdays, there's the anniversary, there's getting together in a social setting. Small group of people enjoying each other's company, like-minded individuals. You can't get no grander than that. Underneath the Fool card, take those unnecessary risks, those risks that you wouldn't have taken before. Have some fun. Okay, not necessarily throw caution to the wind, but just get your ass out there and have some fun. That's not really a problem for Aries, because Aries are not, I don't find too many introverted Aries, trust me. Even on a friendship level, they don't like being confined, but that's all fire signs. They don't like being confined. They like their homes and surroundings and stuff, but they, you know, they got to be out there. So that is no different for you. So these energies that are showing up here is to get yourself out there and about. If you're single, get out and socialize. Okay, there may be somebody to meet socially. Now I know, you know, I haven't received like the star card to indicate, you know, social media, but I don't necessarily need that. Excuse me, because a lot of socializing and stuff could still be going on online. And there still could be an opportunity to meet people and gather in small gatherings, you know, offline. Okay. Fresh start, new beginnings here. Okay. Aries wants a fresh start, new beginnings. Three of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, and Pisces. Your last card is the happiness card. Well, that's your own energy. This card has been showing up in most of these readings here. So this is happiness inside of a structure of a building, sharing the same space with someone that you care about, and there's mutual feelings and love and respect. This also could indicate relocation, moving in together, with, you know, taking the relationship to another level. It's all about that happiness. Okay, but Aries, we must first find out what the devil's influence is that's holding you to keep you from getting to this point here. Someone's still moving, but it's connected to love, or, you know, moving closer to somebody who's in a relationship, or you in a relationship but moving closer to that person. Somehow that's what I'm seeing here, okay? I don't know if that has anything to do with the tower and this universe. Universal shakeup or whatever, but something happens here. All right, so you have good energies to focus on for the next 2 months. All right, so it's looking good in terms of what I see and what I feel. Yeah, some things to work on. Nine of Swords, Devil, some things to work on. Maybe some of the energy comes from the tower. But it's a necessary situation. Something's about to not necessarily rock your world, but something in your world is about to change. And it's going to be on a dramatic or drastic basis. But it may all be necessary for you in moving forward. All right, three cards here from Sandra Brown. And we have reminiscing. Thinking of a past lover. Okay, Aries, are you thinking of somebody from your past? That could be. No harm in that. Just don't get caught up in that fantasy. All right, so the next one here is there's the wedding. Okay, wedding. A ceremony of love is going to happen. I just mentioned that with the Justice card. There's the reception. Somebody getting married in June. And no, this is your reading, so it's not like I'm talking about somebody, you're being invited to somebody's wedding. This is Aries getting married. Some Aries, somebody's getting married. All right, this one here says, find yourself and, what does it say? Find out what is making you feel this way by self-examination. Well, there you go. It says find yourself, and this says find out what is making you feel this way by self-examination. Did I not say that the devil was about you evaluating or examining something about yourself that's restricting you and that is holding you? This card comes in support of your theme for the next 2 months, Aries. Only you know what it is. I can only give you know, some sort of predictive, intuitive impressions, but you know exactly what's going on that is going on too with that devil's energy. All right, so I'm just throwing it out there for you. But this here is like a validation of what I said earlier, that there's something that you need to evaluate that's making you feel some type of way. All right, so that's what I have for you, Aries, for June and July. Thank you, guys. I appreciate you, love you, and it's good to read for you again. Don't know when the next time I'm going to be able to read for you, but again, please enjoy the summer. Enjoy life, be happy, but most importantly, whatever you choose to do, stay safe. I will talk to you soon. Take care.